going to be an awesome time in the robust presence of the Lord. We are so happy to be here, Father. We bless your name this morning, Lord God. Father, we enter in by the blood of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, for all that Jesus has done for us. We thank you, Lord God, for all the plans that you have for us, Lord God. Thank you that there are plans for good and not for evil, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, that you are giving us what we have believed you for, Father, for things that we are expecting from you, Father God. Lord, we thank you for your presence in this place today, Lord. We thank you for your presence that because your presence, it goes everywhere, Lord God. So, Lord, we thank you that your presence is there, Lord God, on Facebook, Lord, that people's needs are going to be met, Lord. We give you thanks. We give you praise, Father. God, we thank you for the precious blood of Jesus. Thank you that Jesus' blood has gotten rid of all guilt, all sin, everything, Lord God. We thank you for the shed blood of Lord Jesus Christ, the last Adam. We bless you today, Father. And we worship you, Lord God. Father, we thank you for our pastors. Thank you, Lord God, for the word that is coming forth from him today, Lord God, by power and by your might, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, that he recalls everything that you have given him, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for their faithfulness. We thank you, Lord God, for their strength, Father. We bless you today, Lord God. We glorify you, Father. We thank you, Lord God, that Jesus is the center, Lord God. We thank you, Jesus, for taking center stage. We thank you, Lord God, that it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by your Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, we welcome you here in this place today. And, sir, we say to you, have your way in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Be glorified, be praised, be lifted and honored, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Good morning, Relentless. Good morning, family. Before I said, it's so good. house of the Lord to be able to speak to his people. Amen.
Bless everyone. Thank you for being here. We welcome you. And all of you that are at home, make sure you connect with us. Hit that share button so we can be a blessing to someone else other than you. Amen. Amen. We believe that this message goes all over the world, so we need to start declaring that we are Relentless Global. That's just not a fancy name.
Yeah.
We believe for the vision of Relentless Global, our church, is that we start at home first in Jerusalem.
Yeah.
We minister in Jerusalem first,
yeah.
Our home first.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all didn't hear me.
Yeah.
Y'all didn't hear me.
Yeah.
See how can you be in church and you can just hear stuff and you don't really hear it? I said we are a Relentless Global church. We will reach the world, but it starts in Jerusalem first. Jerusalem means your house. Ministry is important to me, but ministry does not come before my household.
Right.
My household first.
Yeah.
I'm not going to save the world and lose my daughter.
Come on.
I'm not going to save the world and lose my child.
Right.
Amen. What that look like? My child goes to hell, but I save 5 million other people. What that look like? That's not the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is when they were in jail and Paul and Silas prayed, and the jailer got born again, the jailer went to his house. That's what your jailer did. Before he tried to commit suicide because he was afraid that they were going to run out of jail, Paul told him, hold your hand. Don't kill yourself. We're all here. We're safe. So Paul saved the life of the jailer.
Yes.
Then the jailer said, it's got to be something on Paul and Silas' life for them to sing the song of Zion, for them to give God praise, and then the earth shook.
Yes.
And I declare, the earth shakes for your household.
Yeah.
God moves for you.
Yeah.
Amen. And then he went to his house, and everybody under his roof got saved.
Yeah.
Your house come first.
Yes.
Don't know how I'm going there, but I feel this morning. In Jesus' name. So we're not going to save the world and lose my husband.
Yes.
We're not going to save the world and lose my wife.
Come on.
Amen. We don't have a sure foundation of faith for my household first.
Right.
Then I'm going out throughout the world.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So, amen. Praise God. Last week we talked about our new building product. And so let me set this. I want everybody to relax at home. Take a deep breath. Chill out. God gave me a word for Relentless Global Church. And this is the Lord speaking to your pastor. This is the year of the kingdom of God. There are
no more limits.
And then the 5 words that he gave me to give to the church or the body of Christ are for those of you all over the world who can share the message. And if you can believe it and receive it, this word is for you. No more strain.
Yes.
Meaning you can produce in your life. You don't have to strain to give birth to your vision and in your dreams. No more struggle in life. You don't have to struggle to be married. You don't have to struggle to fall in love.
Right.
You don't have to struggle with raising your kids.
Yeah. Right.
You can do it with grace and class.
Right. Yes. Yeah.
No more stress. Oh, man, that's a biblical. Can you imagine life without stress?
Amen.
You know what the number one issue for heart attacks is?
Right.
Stress.
Yes.
But think about it. No more stress.
Amen.
No more toil. That means no more working hard.
Yes.
No more toil. All the toil is gone, and no more fear.
Amen.
Amen. That's good. No more fear. Now, we're getting ready. We already assigned one of our ministers and one of our board members. We have a realtor. We're getting ready to start looking for other facilities. Thank God for this hotel.
Amen.
But we're moving forward.
Yes.
And we don't have to wait and ask permission to do this.
Yes.
We just make a decision. So now, did God tell me to go get a building? No. Just like God didn't tell me to wear any suit.
Amen.
Did God tell me what kind of car to buy? No, I went and bought the car I wanted.
Right.
Did God tell me what kind of house that I built? My wife and I built our house 18 years ago from the ground up.
Yes.
But God didn't tell me to go buy it.
Yes.
But What did I do? I made a decision. So now, the word that the Lord gave me, I just told y'all what that word was. Yes. And many of you are seeing the kingdom of God already working in you.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
But now we're making a decision as a church to start. But before we start the paperwork process and all the rest of this stuff, the banks don't want your prayer shawl. They don't want your fake information. They want to see your income. They want to see your resources. So now, this plan that we're putting together is to build the income of the church.
Amen.
It's a natural decision we are making.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Because last week we prayed, remember? Things don't happen until we pray.
Right.
So we prayed and asked God to open up a door for a building.
Right.
Now, before our man of God starts going out and doing that, we're going to start sowing in advance.
Yes.
Just like, see, I have to use a lot of natural illustrations to show you a spiritual principle.
Yes.
So let's use your child going to college.
Yes.
You know it costs a lot of money.
Yes.
But you plan in advance.
Yes.
So by the time your child who's in elementary school, you open up an account for that child and you put monies into it because you have an advance plan that my child is going to be educated.
Right.
So you set a plan and you do it in advance.
Amen.
This is the same thing.
Yes.
It's no different.
Yes.
So now we're going to ask the church to sow. So now, again, no pressure because we already got the word. There's no strain.
Absolutely.
Right.
Right.
There's no struggle.
Yes, sir.
There's no stress.
Yes.
So there's no pressure on you to do this.
Amen.
Right. So now what are we asking you to do as a church? We're asking every family to sow a $1,000 seed. That's all. Now, of course, we have businessmen in here. We have educators in here. We have people that are of means in our church.
Amen.
And then we have people that have been laid off, but we've helped them as a church.
Amen.
We have people that have been struggling financially. We've helped them as a church.
Yes,
ma'am. We've sown as a church into the homeless shelters to help other people that are displaced.
Amen.
We've done many things as a church. But how many know you're living what you can do based on what? Finances.
Yes, right.
So as you increase, the church increases.
Amen.
As you prosper, the church prospers.
Yes.
Everybody understand that?
Yes.
So everybody say, no pressure.
No pressure.
So let me give you what this is going to be called for the church. If you go on our website and hit the giving link, you'll see this. Making a Difference.
Amen.
This is the title of our building project. It's called Making a Difference.
Amen.
We're doing this to expand the kingdom of God so we can have children's ministry. Because we're limited with what we can do here. So we can have teens ministry.
Yeah.
So we can do kingdom business. Amen.
Amen.
Because, you know, this ain't the first rodeo we've all been through. Many of us. Amen.
Right.
So again, say no pressure.
No pressure.
Amen. So we're asking every family that are connected to the church and all those that are friends, our partners, our family members, if you so desire, no pressure. Then let's go, let's see. So you say, Pastor, you know I got laid off this day, and I understand. But there's a woman in the Bible who gave
right.
2 cents.
Come on.
In the Bible, she only gave 2 cents.
Yeah.
And she sold it into the offering.
Right.
The Bible specifically says Jesus was watching.
Right.
Yeah.
Come on.
And she was poor, and she was a widow, but she sold.
Right.
Yes, she did.
You know why that was important? And Jesus didn't jump and say, no, sister, you don't have to give because there's a lot of rich folk around here that's giving. You don't have to give. Jesus didn't tell her that. Jesus washed her soul because the only way that you come out of poverty is sowing your way out. Because the kingdom of God is real.
Yes.
The power of God is real.
Yes,
so now let me give you a couple of scriptures and we're going to move on because there's an awesome word today.
Amen.
I promise you.
Amen.
I promise you that.
Amen.
Faith, we're teaching on faith. Faith is always moving. Faith is not, I'm not teaching yet on this, I'm still talking about the giving part. Faith is moving. Faith is an action word. Faith is never sitting still. So why are we going to sit and wait for the pandemic to end, everybody come to church and then they start giving? Why would we do that?
Amen.
Because faith is moving.
Right.
What is the currency of the United States of America? It's money.
Uh-huh.
That's our financial currency. What's the currency in the spirit realm? It's faith. You need both.
Yes, sir.
Now, let me explain this to make myself clear. In this world that we live in, we have access to two worlds. We have access to heaven. We have access to this natural world. And then Joseph saw a ladder going up and down the heaven.
Mm-hmm.
We talked about last Sunday, there's an open, we're under an open heaven.
Yeah.
Heaven is always open.
Yeah.
But everybody will have access.
Right.
You have access by what?
Faith.
You have to have balance. You have to have your natural realm balance. You have to have your spiritual realm. You need both to balance your life. If you're always only spiritual, your husband don't want to be with you.
Right.
Because you can't be only spiritual.
Right.
Nobody wants to talk. I don't like right. spiritual, only spiritual people.
Right.
We have the volleyball game and you want to pray.
Right.
This is not the time to pray.
Right.
I'm trying to enjoy the doggone game.
Right. Right.
So we're not fasting. Right. I want a hot dog. But then, there's a time that some folk can be overly natural.
Yeah.
You involve yourself into too much of carnality to where there's no balance. Y'all understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So now, what I'm saying today is, we're going to be balanced. There's no pressure.
Yeah.
We're not going to pass our cards and say, what you going to give? Just let us know. Write us, email us. You got all our information. Pastor, I'm going to commit to this $1,000. Pastor, I'm going to commit to $2,000. Pastor, I can only commit to $100. Whatever it may be, it's not equal giving, it's equal commitment.
That's it.
Amen.
Yes. Equal commitment. And so now we're moving forward. We're not thinking about the past.
Right.
So we're not thinking about wherever the payroll,
wherever
they may be.
Right.
We're moving forward with the kingdom of God. Amen.
Yes.
Romans 4:17 says, who gives life from the dead and calls those things which be not as though they were? Another translation says, call those things which do not exist as though it does.
Yes.
We prayed last week for a building.
Correct.
Does it exist?
Yeah.
No. But do we have it? Yes. How? By faith.
Yes.
Because we already prayed.
Yes.
Amen. Psalms 105:37 says, he also brought them out with silver and gold. That's the children of Israel. He blessed them with silver and gold that came from favor from the Egyptians, and they didn't need the money. Why did he give them the silver and gold? So they can build a tabernacle,
yes.
a house of God.
Yes.
They didn't need shoes.
Right.
No, yes. We're talking about a supernatural God.
Yeah.
They didn't need clothes.
Yeah.
They didn't need a water pump because God gave them water from a rock.
Right. Right.
They didn't need an air conditioning system. He gave them a pure cloud to cool them by day.
Yeah. Yeah.
They didn't have an AC bill. Y'all better hear what I'm saying.
Yeah.
I'm talking about supernatural.
Supernatural.
Yeah. And then he brought them out with silver and gold, and there was not one sick or feeble amongst them. 2-3 million people, not one headache.
Come on.
Amen.
Come on.
Amen.
See, right now I'm on the inside. Y'all can't see it, but I'm going to flip on this.
Yes.
Because I believe what I'm saying.
Yes. Yes.
3 million people, not a toothache.
Yes. Come on.
Because God sustained them
yes,
in the ghetto or the wilderness or the hood.
Come on, say
amen.
They weren't going to buy it for.
Yes.
Deuteronomy 8:18. You shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he, not your pastor. It is he that gives you what? The power. That's kingdom. To get what?
Wealth.
So how are we going to do this, pastor? God has to increase you.
Amen.
Your house. First.
That's right.
Amen.
Your house
yes.
is your priority.
Yes.
Then this house.
Yes.
But then you can't forget this house.
Right.
See, when God gives you wealth, you can go on vacation. But don't go on vacation and forget this house.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Y'all with me?
Yes.
Y'all with me at home?
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Pastor Lee. This scripture I want you to put up, man of God. This is King David. And then we'll be done with this. This is King David. David was a man of war. He had bloody hands.
Mm-hmm.
Did y'all hear a lesson from Wednesday?
Yes.
We're teaching on the blood.
Oh, my
ooh,
God.
Yeah. Y'all need to wait till next Wednesday.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Man, God loves blood.
Praise
God.
God.
Loves God. But anyway, David has bloody hands because he was a man of war. He fought.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
His hands are defiled. Because God's temple is too holy and too pure, he didn't want bloody hands building.
Right,
yes.
Right.
But David sold.
Yes, he did.
Right.
Yes, he did.
Towards it in the future, and he didn't see it, and he didn't build it.
Wow.
It's kind of like my grandmother, my great-grandparents, sold in the Baptist traditional church, And they sold towards building and building, and then they paid for a couple of pews, and I sat on them.
Yes.
And when I sat there, I heard somebody preach.
Yes.
And when they preached, I gave my life to Jesus.
Come on.
When I gave my life to Jesus, I started serving the Lord. Yes. And then a couple of times, I had to rededicate my life to the Lord. Y'all understand? But I only had that opportunity because somebody sold.
That's right.
Yeah. Now hear me.
Yes,
this is where David sold. And then he says, you have it. 1 Chronicles chapter 22, verse 5. 1 Chronicles chapter 22, verse 5. Amen. Now David said to Solomon, my son is young. Said about Solomon, my son is young, inexperienced. And the house of God must be built exceedingly magnificent, famous, and glorious through all the countries. I will now make what?
Preparations.
This is what we're doing. We're making preparations for the end of this year.
Yeah.
Not only are we making, watch this, preparations for the end of this year, but many of you have sold your visions and your dreams, and you sowed the seed, and we're believing God may happen by men. The end of this year.
Yes.
December what? 31st.
Amen.
Because that's what faith is.
Yes.
Faith is, I'm sowing towards something that's coming to me.
Yes.
Now, by faith, I had it,
yeah.
But the manifestation is, it's coming.
Yeah.
This man knows he's going to die.
Mm-hmm.
This man knows he's not going to see it.
Come on, sir.
Amen.
But he, ooh.
Yeah,
come on. All right.
But he sowed into his son's future that the future generation will benefit from my present preparation.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
See, you think if I ask you to sow $1,000 or $5,000 or $2,000, whatever, you thinking about what they need now, but you're not thinking about your son.
Yes.
You're not thinking about your daughter's legs.
Right.
You're not thinking about my grandmother who we just buried. And again, on behalf of my sister, now I thank you guys for your cards and your gifts of love and your support and your prayer. Again, I don't want to forget to say thank you for supporting us for the loss of our grandmother and my dad as well. So thank you so very much.
Amen.
But they sold.
Yes.
They died.
Uh-huh.
But the seed that they sold into those buildings stand.
Yes, sir.
They're still there to this day.
Amen.
Because somebody before us sold. So you don't think that pastors asked me for a seed so we have another church, another religion, that. No, you got to think kingdom.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Because not church.
Right.
Think kingdom.
Yeah.
Not church.
Right.
Think kingdom. This man is thinking kingdom.
Yes.
So what did he do? So David made an abundant preparation before his what? Death. Y'all see it? Before
yes.
He knows he's about to die. But I cannot die until I sow a seed.
Yes, sir.
Not just for the building, but for Solomon.
Yes.
Are y'all listening to me?
Yes.
Not just the building, but for Solomon.
Amen.
My future son. The future king.
Yeah.
Right.
And then skip down to verse 14. Verse 14. Verse 14 says how much he gave.
Oh my goodness.
He gave 100,000 talents of gold and 1,000,000 talents of silver and bronze.
Yes, sir.
It's estimated when you do the translations and go home and read it, because I already did it.
Yes, sir.
It's estimated that the seed that David sold and the children of Israel at that time was worth well over $400 million, and they did it without a crane.
Mm-hmm.
They did it without seeing it.
Right.
Yes.
They spent $400 million. Anybody ever seen the Taj Mahal?
Yes.
Yes.
Anybody ever read about it?
Yes.
It's one of the most beautiful buildings on earth.
Yes.
They did it. They did it without you. They did it without, they had their way of building it. They still to this day don't know how they built the pyramids, but the pyramids stand.
Right.
Somebody gave.
Yes,
somebody.
Yes, sir.
You just got here by asking somebody sold.
Right.
Yeah.
Now that's that. So now I'm explaining this to you so you can read the scriptures, write it down. You can read the scriptures on Facebook Live and at home. You can hear this message over and over again. This is one man of God that's going to stand, be honest, and tell you the truth, but we're going to do it based on the word. Don't trust what I say, trust what I preach, and go home and study it out. To see what? If it be what?
True.
Come on, if it be what?
True.
Because everything I say has to be based on the word, so you can believe it. Because if the Holy Spirit is not involved in what I'm saying, he won't bear witness where? In your heart.
Amen.
You ought to let him know. Now, something on this.
Right. Amen.
Okay, I'm going to Reverend Pharaoh. I don't know if I like this. But when I say, have to bear witness with your spirit.
Right. Amen.
So now, we're going to solve. Not right now, but we're going to solve. So two things. I'm asking you to go home, pray, set yourself in agreement with your wife or your husband. If you're single, go ahead and pray, and then get an agreement. Once you get an agreement, come back here, baby. We're going to pray. Once you get an agreement, then email us, text us, let us know what your seed is. It doesn't matter what the amount is. If it's $5, be faithful to your five. Because there's no pressure.
Right.
Think about it. We're going to sow, as a matter of fact, but we've been so busy, we're going to sow tonight out $1,000. We're going to sow it.
Amen.
On the website, and it's going to say, making a difference, we'll sow our seed tonight. We're going to be the first to sow.
Amen.
After we do that, now I'm going to believe God.
Yes, come on.
Yes.
Amen.
To bless the works of my hand.
Amen.
Because your increase don't come through the hands of your church or your pastor.
Right.
Your increase comes from God.
Right.
Because it is he that gives you the power to give away.
Yes, sir.
I just believe the reason that this principle hasn't worked for many of the body of Christ, it worked for preachers, but it didn't work for you.
Yeah.
You know the reason why I believe that? Because faith works by love. We got to hear about God and the things of God.
Right.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. So let's just pray. And this is the prayer we're going to pray. God has to increase you. And you have to have an expectation God's going to do it.
Yeah.
And last thing I want to share. My wife and I went to go visit a particular gentleman in a convalescent home to pray with him and all this type of thing. While we were in this area, it was in a pretty like poor kind of area. So we got there early, so we said we're going to stop and get some coffee at a Burger King. Burger? Yeah, we went to Burger King and get coffee. I don't like Burger King. We wanted to get some coffee. So in this coffee, there are a lot of, like, you see homeless people kind of walking around. And this woman came in and just sat down. You could just see she was upset. And my wife kind of talked to her. And then so we bought her breakfast. And so she said, what did they do? They burned her what? She had a tent, so she was poor. In this neighborhood, she had a tent. And somebody burned it.
Oh,
and you can physically see her face. You can see she was upset.
Oh,
so I'm in line ordering the food, and then my wife was talking to me, and I got to check on my queen. I'm like, what the hell? Right over there? You know, so I'm
right.
And she was just ministering to this lady, and I'm like, so we bought her breakfast. It was a simple, simple seed. So this is the word for you. Get into the habit of sowing into people's lives.
Yes. Yes.
Now, I didn't say go bankrupt in your family.
Right.
I'm saying do simple, small things. It's plenty people in your family alone that need some help.
Yeah.
If you can help somebody, sow a seed. And you don't have to let them know it was you.
Yeah.
Pay a light bill if you can.
Mm-hmm.
Fill somebody's car up with gas. Simple, simple things to show love. Amen?
Yeah.
So we're going to ask you to stand and let's go pray. And this is our prayer we're going to pray. God must prosper you.
Amen.
Have some integrity.
Yes,
have
sir.
Some character.
Yes,
do right by God.
Yeah.
Put God first. Tithe.
That's it. Yeah.
Make sure God is the number one priority of your life.
Yeah.
When you put God first, he will honor you, but you must honor God.
Yeah.
All right? So we are the church. Let's be a better example than what we have been in the past.
That's right. Yeah.
So hold your hands in COVID with your families and your wife, husband, y'all hold hands. And you know, all right. You good?
Yes.
Lift your hand. At home, lift your hand. We're going to pray. Heavenly Father. Father, you're the God that visited Moses in the burning bush.
Yes.
You're the God that visited Abraham under his father. You told him to leave and you were blessed.
Yes.
You're the God that spoke to the prophets. You're the God that sent Jesus.
Yeah.
You're the God that raises up one and you can set down another.
Yeah.
You are the God that opened up the Red Sea and you made a way.
Right.
Yes. You're the God that did it for our foreparents. You did it for our parents, and you're doing it for us today.
Yes.
Father, we bless you and honor you, and this is the request that we have. You said that you would prosper us.
Yes.
Lord, we ask that you would do that today.
Thank you.
Prosper us that we may build your house.
Yes.
Prosper us that we may sow and tithe.
Yes.
Prosper us that we may give you the glory and the honor and the kingdom.
Yes.
And in exchange, Father, show us
yes.
your glory.
Yes.
Manifest the kingdom. Father, wherever we may work, let the people know where we work, that there's something on us.
Yes.
That there's something different about us.
Yes.
That they look at us and they see the face of an angel.
Yes.
Because your glory rests upon us.
Yes.
Father, restore our homes. Restore our marriages. Restore our children. None of our children shall be lost.
Yes.
And just like the children of Israel, there was not one sick or feeble amongst the people of Israel.
Yes.
So we declare peace
yes.
over your home.
Yes.
Peace over your family.
Yes.
Health and healing is your covenant
yes.
right. Father, we honor you. We love you. We put you first. And as we prepare to teach the word, open up our hearts
yes, Lord.
To receive this fresh word of faith.
Yes.
And we bow
yeah, Lord.
To give you the glory.
Yes.
We bow to honor your name.
Yes.
We vow that no flesh shall be glorified in your sight.
Yes.
We love you, Lord.
I love you, Lord.
And we believe we receive it now.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Yes.
Let's give the Lord a hand for the praise. Amen. 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 If you have your Bibles, turn to Galatians chapter 5, verse 6. We're teaching on faith, and I guess this is lesson number 3.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen.
We're teaching on faith works by love. I think this is probably for me. I've been in church my whole life. My wife and I were raised. My sister and I, we were raised in church our whole life. We know church. I say it. Did y'all hear me? We know church.
Church, right. Church.
But we did not know King.
Right. Yes.
Y'all heard that?
Yes, sir. Yes.
And so now, I think one of the most important missing ingredient in the message of faith is love.
Yes.
God is
love.
And God is a spirit.
Yes.
And the scripture says, for in Christ, there is neither circumcision or circumcision. That means flesh. That means flesh.
Yes.
Flesh doesn't produce faith. Flesh
yes.
doesn't produce the kingdom.
Yes.
So your bad attitude not going to work for you, so you need to change it.
Come on.
So if you've been robbing and stealing from God, that's the flesh. You need to change it.
All right.
So if you haven't been treating your wife right or your husband right, that's the flesh. It's hindering your faith.
All
right.
Yes, it is.
Oh, I'm giving somebody out there. If you are married, and you're not treating your spouse respectfully, you are not walking in the spirit, you're walking in the flesh. So some of us need to go home and apologize.
Yes. Yes.
So that your faith can work.
Yes.
Some of us need to go home and sit down and apologize to our children. So we can put our house together, we can be on one accord. Your child and your son, if your child is of age of understanding, and they can play Nintendo and play all Xbox and they can play all these games, they can understand faith.
Amen.
Yes,
you just need to be a parent.
Come on.
And sit down and set some priorities in your house. And say, son, we're going to learn about faith. We're going to watch Pastor on Facebook Live.
That's it.
And let Pastor teach to us. Amen.
Amen.
So now, the Lord gave me a will and a middle will. And I knew it was in the Bible. I just didn't know where it was. I had to look it up. So it's Ezekiel chapter 1, verse 15. Don't turn there, just give you a reference. When the Bible talks about a will and a middle will, it's talking about there's no beginning to God. There's no ending to God.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But God is accessed by faith.
Right.
There's no beginning. You don't know when God was born. Or you don't know if God can even die. You don't know anything about that. But you believe he exists.
Amen.
Yeah. Can't be, man. This is some of these spiritual principles, man. You really have to learn to be still, be quiet.
Yes.
To get a revelation.
Yes.
A will and a middle of a will is ever living. God never dies. Amen. So faith never dies.
Amen.
Never.
It's all things working together for my good.
Uh-huh.
A will. In the middle of a wheel, faith moving constantly.
Right.
Whether I'm awake, it's working.
Right.
Whether I'm asleep, it's working.
Right.
Whether people love me,
amen.
It's working.
Yes.
Whether people hate me, it's working.
Right.
Whether I'm black, it works.
Right.
Whether I'm white, it works.
Right.
It's a matter of getting before God and getting an understanding of what makes faith work.
Amen.
So now, 10 get references. What is faith? It's the Greek word pistis, P-I-T-I-S. It means conviction of truth. As I'm teaching to you about this building project that we named, you already know in your heart if this is something I'm going to participate in. You already know it before I end it.
Yes,
as I'm teaching on faith, you already in your heart, you know if this is something I need. Yes. You already know without discussing it with me.
Right.
It's a conviction of truth. And the problem with the church is there's no conviction of truth. That's why sin can run rampant in the church, because the man who sits on the wall to tell you the truth doesn't tell you the truth. That's why we got what we got in the church.
Come on, man.
We got homosexual pastors in the church.
Correct.
Because someone didn't tell the truth. Number two, faith is the Hebrew word emunah. E-M-U-N-A-H. I tell you these things so you can go study and see if what I'm telling you is true. Yes. If you don't believe me, you won't believe what God said. Because I'm getting the revelation from the Lord, but I'm also doing the study so you can hear the scriptural references and go see it for yourself.
Yes,
sir. Amen.
Amen.
It means, it's an action word that means support. Mm-hmm. Let's use healing. Hands in my body, the doctor says I got 5 days to live. I can accept what he says or I can reject what he says.
Amen.
I can choose as an act of my will to believe what the word says. So now I'm standing on the word for healing.
Yes.
And all of a sudden, it carries me.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Uh-huh. All of a sudden, it supports me.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Faith is when I believe God, watch this, if I die, I die believing.
Yes. Right.
Amen.
Right.
Because I have a conviction of truth is what God's word says for me is the truth.
Yes.
Yes.
Like gay marriage. Did God change? No. No, he didn't. Now, is the world saying two men or two women out there? I'm not mad at what nobody says. I'm not here to judge you. But I am here to tell you the truth. That God honors a man and a woman. Now, I'm not here to fight you. But if I don't stand and tell you the truth, you will die in your sins while I'm up here trying to buy business.
Oh, wait.
Come on, sir. Yes.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
Come on. Preach, Pastor.
Come on.
Because the kingdom of God is about a conviction of truth. The only way that your faith will increase is faith comes by hearing. But someone has to tell you the truth. And that's how your faith is increased, right? By your personal conviction. Like right now, I said what I just said, you already know it's true.
Right. Right.
I'm not going to buy you, pay you to believe what I just said is true. Because God says, I change not. So his principles don't change.
Amen.
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 Now, what is faith? Real quick. Faith is the basic ingredient. Watch this. Basic ingredient to have a relationship with God. Faith is not about what I can get. Faith is about a relationship with a man named Jesus.
Amen.
Number two. Number four. Faith is the assurance of things revealed in the Word. Faith comes by a revelation. What is revelation? Watch this. In my coat, I have this guy for money. You can't see it.
Right.
I have a wallet in my pants pocket right now. You cannot see it. But if I take it out and open it up, what's happening? It just got what?
Revealed.
Yeah.
That's what revelation is.
Yeah.
It's the revelation of the truth of the word that's been opened to you.
Amen.
Not just, watch this, not just based on what I preach, it's based on what you study and pursue.
Yeah.
You have to go after truth.
Amen.
And see, we hear scriptures in church because we're churchy. It is the truth that will set you free. Watch this. It's the truth that will set you free from anything that binds you. So what should we go after? Truth.
Yes,
sir.
Absolutely.
Amen.
Number five. Faith is a spiritual substance that produces natural evidence. If I keep talking about it, you'll see it.
Absolutely.
If I keep praying about it, you'll see it. If I want a car, a particular kind of car, all of a sudden, when I'm driving, I can see that car.
Right.
Everywhere God has said is true, committing my life to it.
Amen.
Number seven, faith is a complete confidence in Christ's finished work. When Christ died on the cross, he said it is finished. The middle ball of partition tore from the top to the bottom, and there's access to God through the veil of Jesus' flesh.
Yes.
So now, that's only true if I believe.
Yeah. Right.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Just like the blood of Jesus Christ. I can declare the blood over my life and be free from nicotine.
Amen.
But I have to believe.
That's
right.
Amen.
Amen.
Number eight is, faith is your intellect plus your emotions. That's why in the Spanish and Old Baptist church, they were shocked. That's because what they heard convicted them and their emotions kicked in.
Yes.
That's why you get crap in church.
Yes.
That's why you can lift up your hands and you almost don't know why. That's why you can run around.
Uh-huh.
Or that's why you fall to the knees and prostrate and you just worship the Lord in the house of God in front of everybody.
Yeah.
Because my emotions are attached to what I believe. Glory to God. Number nine, faith is God's work in us that changes us from the inside out. Number 10, faith is from Martin Luther. Martin Luther said, faith is a living, bold trust in God's grace. God's grace, so certain of his favor on my life that it would risk death 1,000 times over.
Wow.
Let me tell you what he's saying.
Yes.
He's saying,
wow,
if it comes down to
yes,
death,
yes,
and my personal conviction,
uh-huh,
that you're trying to steal from me and tell me it don't work,
mm-hmm,
you're trying to tell me I can't be healed, you're trying to tell me I can't be happy, you're trying to tell me I can't fall in
yes,
love, you're trying to tell me my child can't graduate,
right,
you're trying to tell me he's going to be a deadbeat,
yes.
No. I'm willing to die based on my personal
right,
conviction.
Yes.
I believe
yes,
God.
Yes. Yes.
And listen to me, you have to this year,
yes,
in the midst of a pandemic,
yes,
you have to believe God on his word, and you have to hold fast to that irregardless of what you see. Your mama can die, your daddy can die, your husband can leave, your child can curse you out to your face. At the end of the day, nothing is going to shift me.
Come on.
Because of my personal conviction.
Yes, amen.
Glory to God.
Amen.
We went to Acts chapter 7. We looked at a man named Stephen. Acts chapter 7, verse 54. Stephen was now a pastor. Stephen was now a bishop, evangelist, teacher. Stephen was a deacon. He was the type of a custodian. He was a type of Sunday school teacher, parking lot teacher. In other words, he was really sort of irrelevant. He was a no-name, but he loved God.
Wow.
He was a no-name, but he was filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
He was a no-name, but he was laying hands on the sick and they recovered.
Come on, sir.
Yes.
So when this man, Stephen, stood and was talking to the Jews, the Bible says, verse 54, that they heard his word and they were cut to the heart.
Come on.
Because the word was so convicting. And that's what we need in the church. A word that will convict you. The Bible says the Holy Ghost, after I preach, not out of faith, but out of the Holy Ghost, it is the Holy Spirit that will convict you of sin.
Yes.
Not me.
Yes.
It's the Holy Ghost that will convict you of righteousness.
Yes.
Make it a change because I want to do
yes,
what's right because it's right.
Yes.
Amen. It's the Holy Spirit that will convict you
yes,
to let you know the man of God is telling you the truth.
Yes.
So let's go to new information. 1 Thessalonians chapter 3, and then we're going to go into what faith is not.
All right.
1 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 1 through 7. See if we can get through this one. Now, I'm going to show you through Paul how important your faith really is. Therefore, when we can no longer endure it, we're talking about persecutions, we found it good that we leave or left Athens alone, left them alone, because them folk in Athens were crazy, they didn't want the word. So, you know, what's the Bible saying to do when people won't receive you? Kick the dust from your feet, move on. You don't hang around people who don't want to receive you.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus had the rich ruler. The man was rich, the man was young, but the man rejected Jesus.
Right.
And you don't read what Jesus chased him down.
Yeah.
I'm the Messiah. I'm the Messiah. Please receive this word. And Jesus went on to the next town.
Yes, sir.
So when a that the Thessalonica, see, I need to talk here, the Thessalonians.
Uh-huh.
But there is Thessalonica.
Yes.
I'm trying to get this right.
Yes.
Y'all don't get mad at me for preaching so good. The Thessalonians need to be encouraged.
Mm-hmm.
They need to be prayed for. They're a young, small church. So Paul says, as a father in the ministry, like a father should, the father was only concerned about the people. So I'm going to send some support to you by sending young Timothy to support y'all. How did he support them? Through the preaching of the gospel that came through Paul. Where did Paul get from? Paul got a revelation from Jesus because Paul was in the third heaven.
Amen.
So he got a revelation. That's why Paul is one of the only few prophets who can say, follow me as I follow Christ. Because he was credible.
Yes.
You got to see some results.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Watch this. I sent Timothy, my brother, my minister, my fellow laborer of the gospel, to do what? To establish you. That's teaching the word. To encourage you.
Uh-huh.
That's your faith. Watch what he says. Concerning your what?
Faith.
Church growth.
Nope.
I'm going to send Timothy to the church of the Thessalonians to see how well the church is growing.
No.
That's not what he said.
Right.
I'm sending Timothy to check on the building project to see if they'll give it consistently.
No.
That's why I'm sending Timothy, right?
No.
Oh, okay, I'm wrong. Maybe he sent Timothy to check on the tithes and offering because I'm the evangelist. I need y'all to give so I can keep doing what I'm doing out here.
No.
That's not why he sent Timothy.
No.
Maybe.
Yes.
He wanted to check out the TV program and see what the ratings are.
Come on.
How much income coming in on TV so I can sell my tapes and CDs?
Come on.
Come on, Pastor. That's it.
Now, am I against any of that? Absolutely not. You got to tithe. You got to support. You got to build a building. You got to do this. But that's not why he was sent.
Come on.
See, some of y'all at home are at home because you're lazy. Some of you at home because you legitimately need to be home to protect yourself. But some of y'all at home and not giving to the things of God, but you'll watch me on Faith and Love teach you the truth, and you'll still stay home and wonder why you're struggling.
Yeah.
Come on, Pastor.
Because you, many of you at home, are using the pandemic as an excuse not to do what Timothy did.
That's it.
So we're opening up another service so you can be comfortable, so you can come in the house of God and hear the man of God pour the word into you.
Right.
But some things you can't get at home.
Come on.
How about that?
That's true.
Some things that the anointing comes in the house under the words of the man of God as the word are floating on top of the anointing.
Yeah.
And sometimes that only happens in the house.
That's right.
Y'all want to know who the number one financial supporters of Relentless Old Church is? The elders above 70.
How about that?
And I told them, don't come to church. Stay home. Because they're at risk because of their age.
Yes, sir.
So I told them, we went to their houses.
Come on now.
Sat with them. Because this is ministry.
Correct. Correct.
Not to get something out of you.
Oh.
But to be concerned about the people of God.
Yes.
Paul sent Timothy to the church to check on their faith.
Oh.
Yes.
My.
Period.
Yep.
I'm the apostle of the church. That's what Paul is saying. As pastors Leroy and Betty Barnes are the apostles of Relentless Global Church.
Correct.
But it's Paul's job to make sure the church is safe and secure.
Yeah.
So what he says was the priority of the church, not their giving, their faith.
Yes, sir. That's it.
It says it right there.
Right.
Yeah.
And he says it very clear.
Yes.
Yes.
That I sent Timothy on my
Amen.
He was only concerned about their faith, not their finances. Wow. He was concerned about their faith, not their houses.
Wow.
He was concerned about their faith, not the latest car that just came out 2021.
Come on.
All right.
Oh, my.
Amen.
That's it.
Yes, sir.
True.
And if the fivefold ministry gift can get back to this,
yep,
the church will rise.
Yes,
and have a level of respect.
Come on!
Because the church today that we're living in have no respect.
No respect.
Because many of us have sold ourselves,
yep,
for what we can get.
Come on, sir.
Lord have mercy.
Faith works by what?
Love.
Faith works by what?
Love.
I wrote this down this morning. I want to get it. I wrote it down this morning. I want to make sure I say it. Faith works by what?
Love.
Here it is. Okay. Love,
yes, sir,
doesn't ask what I can get.
Oh, my.
Christ died while I was yet in my sins.
Yes.
He had already given before I knew he existed.
Yes, sir.
Y'all can hear that. See, there's a revelation coming that you need to really hear. Christ died before I was born.
Yeah.
Love was already extended to me before I came here.
Yeah.
The Bible was already written before I learned how to read.
Yeah.
Love was already extended,
yeah,
before I knew what sin was.
Right.
Love showed up on the scene.
Yes.
Love doesn't ask what I can get. Love doesn't ask what I need.
Yeah.
Love doesn't say, this is what I want. What true love is, love gives. That's why the enemy works on the church when it comes to spiritual giving for the right reason and for the right purposes. People are afraid of it because they found a lot of these folk.
Right.
I'm from Arizona. I'm trying to watch my godly lips. A lot of these people didn't tell you the truth.
Right.
And a lot of the sheep were scattered.
Correct.
Because they found out that what I was believing in did not work for me. When God never lies. Because love gives.
Love gives.
That's what love does. Love gives. So now, let me go to how. Make sure I'm in the right place. I got so many notes. Praise God.
Praise God.
Praise God. Y'all give me just one second. I can go back and get some more questions. What faith is not? Here we go. Y'all ready?
Yes, sir.
We talked about what faith is. Okay, my wife says again, I went over my time. So y'all work with me a couple minutes.
Yes.
Because I got to do this today to start it off so we can pick it up this week. Yes. What faith is not? Number one, Acts chapter 20, verse 34. And we'll probably pick it up next week. Faith is not a get rich scheme.
Amen.
Faith,
thank you, Lord,
is not your spiritual life.
Oh, God.
Faith, yes, is not your glorified Las Vegas.
Amen.
We're talking about what faith is not. Yes. Acts chapter 20, verse 34. Yes, you yourselves know that what? These hands. Everybody look up for a second.
Mm-hmm.
I want y'all to get this because some of this connect with vision.
Yes, sir.
Read this with me real quick. Yes, you yourselves know that what?
These hands.
Another scripture says, put your hands to the plow. What does it mean?
Right.
Work.
Right.
It means discipline.
Yes.
It means craft.
Yes.
It means educated.
Yes.
Wow.
It means you got to get up and make your way prosperous.
Right.
It don't mean sit at home, go to sleep, and wait for God to do something. He already said on Calvary's cross, it is finished.
Come on.
So now, you and I need to get up and go to work.
That's,
yeah,
right.
Amen.
Some of us need to go back to school.
True.
Some of us need to increase our education.
Yes.
Yeah. Some of us just need to get rid of certain folk out of your life that's slowing you down for progression.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Yes.
These hands have provided for my necessities and for those who were with me. Who's saying that? Paul. Who's the anointed prophet? Paul.
Yeah.
Who's the evangelist? Paul.
Paul.
Who's the missionary? Paul. Who's working? Because they're so tired of the games.
Yes. Oh, sure.
Yep.
But at the end of the day, the Lord has to prosper your hands.
Yes.
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 That's why whatever your vocation is, he has to anoint you where you are.
Right.
Come on. He has to increase you where you are. That's why when I say you gotta go back to school, or you gotta get educated, you gotta take the class, or you gotta do whatever you gotta do to increase you. And the grace, like the ointment, is rubbed on you. The education becomes easy.
Yeah.
The learning becomes easy.
Yeah.
You're right. The word carries you and raises you up. It happens so slow, you don't see it happening.
Come on now.
But then you wake up in 2022.
That's
it.
And I'll tell you another trick of the enemy. There's a lot of spiritual perception with the pandemic, because the pandemic came from the pits of hell.
Yes.
But one for sure is to make the church lazy. You can't believe how easy it is to sit at home, watch TV, eat, and get fat.
Yeah.
And then don't want to pray.
Right.
Don't want to read. Watch this. Don't want to go to church.
Yeah.
And watch this. Don't want to sow. Watch this. No prayer, no seed in the ground. You're lazy, and your health is deteriorating, and you don't even understand the trick that's working around you to keep you out of church.
Amen.
It's a trick of the enemy.
Yes, sir.
And then any your church, saints, now everything that you and your wife don't get along with, y'all at home all day. Your child irritating you because he don't go to school, so y'all around each other all day. Now I got really parents. Glory be to God. I really got to talk to this child and pray him. But watch this. We have the grace of God. That's why you can't disconnect from church. Facebook Live is justified when it goes to a certain point.
Yes.
You stay in this situation, you're going to find yourself withdrawing from God.
Yes. Right.
Yes.
So true.
Because I tell you, one of the clear ways of sinning is based on your giving. Because you only give to what you love.
That's right.
Yes, sir. I don't care who you are.
Yes,
you can be Buddhist,
yeah.
You can be Muslim.
Yeah.
That principle works.
Right.
You only give to what you love. And if you don't love God, you won't give.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
And people are laid off.
Amen.
But you think the kingdom of God can't get you a job?
It's true.
People at home sick.
Yeah.
Do you really believe the kingdom of God can't make you well?
Wow.
But people in the midst of a pandemic use this as an excuse to stay home. But it's amazing. You'll get up and go get your hair nailed done, but you're not proud. It is so amazing how you get up and go to work. But I'm not sure about going to church. I just want to be careful.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, it's a pandemic. But you went to work.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on, bro.
It's a spiritual excuse that will eventually take you down. And when you fall, you will be calling me to pray for you. So I'm not telling you trying to manipulate somebody to come to church, no. But what I am saying is judge your heart.
Yes.
Why we do what we do.
Yes.
Because if we're going to walk by faith, faith works by love. God is love. That means I put God first. And that's all I'm saying. I'm simply saying judge your heart. One of the words that the Lord has given that there is no more fear.
Amen.
I didn't say don't use wisdom.
Right.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I said we don't walk in fear.
Right.
I didn't say don't. I didn't say like I'm gonna take off your mask. No, put your mask on.
Mm-hmm.
Wash your hands.
Right.
Do what we need to do to protect ourselves. Because it simply just amazes me how we justify it for work. We justify it for the mall.
Mm-hmm.
We justify it for Kroger's, Walmart, and the my car to go where?
That's it. That's the truth. That's it.
Ooh. You fill up with super unleaded to go where? And you can't direct yourself to the house of God.
Come on, sir.
Come on.
I mean, seriously.
Yeah.
I'm just letting you know so you can understand Pastor's heart.
Yeah.
Wisdom. And we're going to use wisdom.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the day, after we use our wisdom, we're going to make a godly decision. Yeah. I have never asked me, should I take the shot or are you going to take the shot? It's not up to me to tell you to take a shot or not to take a shot.
Right.
But it is up to me to tell you, go study it,
right.
Read it, get some understanding, get some wisdom, and then what? Make a decision for you.
Right.
As the pastor of this church, I'll say it again, I'll repeat myself, it is my job to teach you the word. It is my job to direct Relentless Global Church, but it is not my job to direct your house.
That's right.
Come on.
That's not my job. So when I step in your house and you got ashtrays in the room, I can tell you don't smoke.
Right.
But when you step in my house, you won't find an ashtray anywhere. Because
right.
You're not allowed to smoke.
Right.
You understand?
Right.
So what I'm saying to you is this. I believe in my heart that when we understand the principle of faith or what it really is, that it's really about love and a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. When we align things the right way, God is going to supernaturally skyrocket your life.
Amen.
And I can't wait to hear the testimony.
Yeah.
My business doubled. We already have one business man. His business has doubled. He got 5 people to hire. And this brother came to me and said, I need to sow into something.
Yes, sir.
Because he's found out that the principle of the kingdom works. Because it works by love.
Amen.
Every head bowed, every eye closed, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for the study of your word.
Thank you,
Lord, for the revelation. Thank you, Lord, for the wisdom. And thank you, Lord, for the understanding. If you're not born again at home or in this house, as we teach, as the anointing is in this place, Lord, we thank you. That if you're not born again, we give your life to Jesus. Everything that I taught, it begins with a revelation of Jesus Christ. Commit your life to him. If you can just confess with your mouth, believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, the Bible says you shall be saved.
Yes.
If you believe that, if you confess that, guess what? I'm saved, I'm born again.
Yes.
And we want to connect with you. For those of you who are not a part of Relentless Global Church, connect with us via email, Facebook, and our church address. All the information is at our website at www.relentlessglobalchurch.org. Please call the church office. Let us know that you gave your life to Jesus. And for those of you who are members at home and those of you who are in this house, if you're not a member of this church and you desire to be a member of this church, lift your hands and raise your hand. Let us know you're making a decision. It's okay. We want to make sure that your spiritual need is met. We want to make sure every need for your household, every need for you is met, because the Spirit of Christ can do it for you. And we thank you, Father. And we declare every need is met in Jesus' name. Amen. Put your hands together. I will give the scripture for today, if you can put it up there, God. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 15. And again, we just gave you our plan for our giving. And for those of you, we've already asked you, if you go on Facebook Live, you can hear this message over and over again. Yes, ma'am. Making a difference, go to our website. Click on our giving link, you'll see it. We're believing and asking those who are family, friends, and loved ones of this ministry to sow $1,000 seed. And if you can, whatever seed that you're able to sow, as we plan to start looking for a building and transition from this place, from our Egypt to our promised land.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
But let's look at this scripture real quick. This is, again, I believe the Apostle Paul talking. Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise. That is what? The fruit of our lips.
Giving thanks to his
name. Amen. And confess his name. Giving thanks to his name. Verse 16. And don't forget this. Watch what he says. Don't forget this. Now we done praised him.
Amen.
We done shouted.
Yes.
We done said our hallelujahs.
Amen.
But don't forget.
Yes, sir.
To do good and to share with others
For with such sacrifice, God is well pleased. So God is pleased with your giving. Now watch this. I already gave the word, start learning to share, sow into the lives of others. You know, do little things to be a blessing. But you can't do that apart from the church. You got to give to the support the things of God. That's your tithes and your offerings. Now, verse 17 says obey your leaders, but that's been abused. About your leaders, but we don't skip that part. But it's that. Nonetheless, support your leaders and be respectful and all that, right? That's verse 17. Let's get down to verse 20. Now, after you give it, after you support it, and see, when I give you scripture, saints, listen, I so sincerely mean this. Go home. Read them in their context so you can get, I don't have time to read the whole chapter based on time.
All right.
I can only give you certain views of it, right? Mm-hmm. But you can go home and read it in its context so you can see the flow of what Paul was saying before he gets to this verse. But he says, give, and then verse 20 says, may the God of peace. Man, you see, that's big. That's really big. After you give into your church, after you blessed humanity, after you took somebody like you just bought them a hamburger, just to do something that's kingdom-like to help somebody else to encourage them.
Yeah.
Yes.
Amen.
God releases peace.
Amen.
That is huge.
Yes, sir.
And then he says, who through the blood, and I was excited when I read this one because I'm teaching on the blood on Wednesdays.
Yes.
Who through the blood of the eternal covenant brought back Jesus from the dead, that great shepherd, what will he do? He will equip you.
Yes, amen.
He will equip you with every good for you doing his will. What is his will? You're giving to support others.
Yes.
Not just you.
Amen.
Do you really believe that God's going to bless you financially so you can bless your family, bless your church, bless your family, bless your children, and leave you broke?
Come on.
Come on. You can't. You got to be. You have to be more intelligent than that. Why do you think billionaires have what is it, trust? What do they call it?
Endowments.
Why do you, they don't only do that for a tax break.
Right.
They do it to set up a legacy.
Right.
That this company called Compaq or Microsoft have given to educational things so they can bring up another generation to come into tech to help them stay on top.
Right.
They're about investing in somebody else. The Bible says when you give to your kingdom, give to your God, and you give to others, he releases peace.
Yes.
Giving is your way out.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But people don't understand Revelation.
Yes. Amen.
Because it's more blessed. Oh, my goodness. Yes.
Yes.
More blessed. Watch this. I'm already blessed. But it's more blessed to give than it is to receive. You know why? Because until you give, you're sowing a seed, a harvest must come.
That's right.
It's got to.
Yes, sir.
It's got to. God sends a word out and says, I'm going to create the earth, the moon, the sun, and the stars. They obey. His word did not return unto him void. Because his words were true.
Yes.
Now, I can give you this prophetic word all day. Until you sow, you won't know that it works.
Amen.
My wife and I have done it over our time. Every year we find some child that needs school clothes. Of course, the pandemic happened a little, that's a little different. But every year prior to the pandemic, we found one family that needed kids to support them with school clothes. We found somebody. Mm-hmm. It's always somebody. Y'all know that, right? You know the reason why we did that? Because when we were raising our children, they didn't realize that we were struggling financially. But God raised up people like my sister to buy them school clothes. Tennis shoes. She bought me tennis shoes. For years, from middle school to high school. But that income came in. Because he can prosper you without money. God raised up other people to help us. We had five kids, and it was a struggle financially. But God opened up doors, and the money came. Now we're at a place where we're blessed financially. So now, what kind of man of God would I be? Forget man of God. What kind of person would I be
yes, sir.
If I didn't sow into others?
problem when God so graciously sold it to me.
Yes. Amen.
Yes.
Thank you.
That's why we got to give.
Right. Yes,
so, and notice the scope that I'm giving you. I'm not talking about only the church.
Right.
Yes. Right. I'm talking about your whole life must be a seed.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Amen. So if you're ready to give, just raise up your hand if you need an envelope. For those of you that are at home, go to our website at www.relentlessglobalchurch.org. You can sow your tithes, offering this love, and for our new project called
Making a Difference.
I need my wife. Take off my wife. Yeah. Are you ready to give? Come. Let's go ahead and sow, and let's give. Amen. And God bless you at home. We appreciate you so very much. Thank you for tuning in with us today. And we hope that you heard our heart. So go home and pray about sowing into the ministry. But beyond that, we hope that you have a blessed week. Take care of your family. Stay safe. And we will see you on Wednesday. We'll teach you on the blood of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. We'll see you on Wednesday. Let's give him a hand.